بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear friends, we mentioned that Max Weber, a sociologist from Germany, also he's an economist and politician. He came up with a book in 1904 with the name Protestant Ethics and the Spirit of Capitalism. And in that book, he specifies the Calvinist ideas, which is mainly Protestant ideas of Martin Luther, but he went more far away from the Catholic. And he dwelled on the issue of predestination, which means in God's knowledge, before even the whole universe was created, he knows who is destined to be in heaven and who is destined to be in hell. And we know this is true in our religion. From many, many ayahs in the Quran al-Kareem, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ties everything to His will. The heaven, the earth, hell, heaven, and you name it, everything in God's hand and God's will. And if anyone, when he is born, if he is shaqiyun am sa'id, if he is doomed or if he is saved. This hadith عن عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يا غلام إني أعلمك كلمات احفظ الله يحفظك احفظ الله تجده تجاهك إذا سألت فاسأل الله وإذا استعنت فاستعن بالله واعلم أن الأمة لو اجتمعت على أن ينفعوك بشيء لم ينفعوك إلا بشيء قد كتبه الله لك وإن اجتمعوا على أن يضروك بشيء لم يضروك إلا بشيء قد كتبه الله عليك رفعت الأقلام وجفت الصحف. In another hadith, ayah which says قل لن يصيبنا إلا ما كتب الله لنا predestined هو مولانا وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون. Say, never will be struck except by what Allah has decreed for us. He is our protector, and upon Allah let the believers rely. Another hadith which emphasized this issue, from the moment of conception, when the sperm meets the egg, in the mother's womb. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أحدكم يجمع في بطن أمه 40 يوما ثم علقة مثل ذلك ثم يكون مضغة مثل ذلك ثم يبعث الله ملكا فيؤمر بأربعة برزقه وأجله وشقي أو سعيد فوالله إن أحدكم يعمل بعمل أهل النار حتى ما يكون بينه وبينها غير باع أو ذراع فيسبق عليه الكتاب فيعمل بعمل أهل الجنة فيدخلها وإن الرجل ليعمل بعمل أهل الجنة حتى ما يكون بينه وبينها غير ذراع أو ذراعين فيسبق عليه الكتاب فيعمل بعمل أهل النار فيدخلها. So everything is predestined. also there's a issue of sincerity of the deeds and the issue of the lesser shirk. All Muslims are very much anxious and preoccupied with the issue of ikhlas. We read in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. So it is issue of the all along sincerity and the purity of and the dedication of their good deeds for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, one more issue is khawatim al-amal, which means, as the hadith says, you might be good all along, you may make kufr or something bad and erase everything, and vice versa. You might be bad all your life, then you do some act of goodness and it erases everything and you go to heaven. And all of us, we know the story of that woman who was with bad behavior. She saved a dog, and we know a man who removed a branch of a tree, and all of them were forgiven and taken to heaven. So here, what Mark Weber is saying in his book, he's saying that, and he believes, and his followers, they believe, and Mark Weber is saying that this is what triggered the explosion of knowledge, industry, agriculture, and booming of economy, and everything in the West, especially the Northern Europe and United States, Canada, and Australia, is due to this point, predestination. So that predestination leaves us anxious and guilty, and not knowing where we are going to end. And for him, here I remember the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was asked, is your good deed will enter you in heaven? Paraphrasing, he said, no. Illa an yataghammadani Allahu bi rahmati. It is God's grace which will enter me to heaven. So the work comes for Weber, the work comes as a consequence of the faith in God and the predestiny. So he felt that to manage or to address this anxiety and guilty feeling, only hard work and success financially, money, and making factories, working unemployed, and hospitals, and all these great charitable work is a way to tell God that I'm good and I deserve to be in heaven. And from that developed what we call the Puritan ethic work, or the Protestant work ethics, which all of us we know, and this is a characteristic of the early American, as described by Alexis de Tocqueville, hard-working family men, women, great housewives, and strong-willed, and teaches kids moral values to be true men in the field and society. And those men who are working very hard, they make money, they are frugal in their life, they don't waste, and they reinvest the money in more projects and so on. And all of this cascaded to make America the richest and the strongest country in the world. So Max Weber believed that religion, especially Calvinism and Protestantism, what changed everything. And this is something for our atheists and our people who look at religion as a backward and like it is the reason for our predicaments, from poverty and illness and illiteracy and so on, that lack of religion is our problem. And I have to emphasize, religion is like fruit. Not all fruits are alike. There's good fruits and bad fruits for your health. So Islam, I don't mean Islam of fatalism and Islam of looking for solution at the graves of dead people, or Islam of laziness and sitting doing nothing except repeating some words for a half a million time a day and paralyze their lives. This is will lead, like the rest of the people of the earth, one of the reasons of their backwardness. This fatalism, this laziness, this religion which is based on utterance and talk, and nobody is willing to move a branch from the street to clean it. Here, Islam is a work. So, for Max Weber, also he said that Calvinism cherish every honest work. It's not only the priests and the scholastic knowledge and talking, argumentation, this will lead to nothing. He emphasizes that all vocations, all work is holy and respected. And that's doing all of this will be pleasing to God when you earn money and feed your family and feed your neighbors and do good things and so on and so on. And for Weber also, family is very important, but not to forget the motive here, selfish. And he looks out of the family to community. And community, which is Jama'ah, and this is something very big in Islam, not our Jama'ahs, where you come and go and nobody knows nobody. This is not Jama'ah. Jama'ah is to care about each other. So the community is very important in Calvinism. And there where you show the qualities of selflessness and the good deeds for society and so on. Also for Max Weber in his book, he stated that Calvinism do not rely on miracles. That time is over and past. Now to solve problems, you go to science and knowledge. And this is what we witnessed in the West, of explosion of knowledge and so on. The bottom line for him, that this change of thought triggered all of these cascades of massive achievements in the history of mankind. Change of thought, the ideals, from that simple predestiny led to everything we know about the West and the advanced countries. So we read in the Quran that God will not change your condition till you change your thoughts inside yourself. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. May Allah bless you all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.